In one of the sessions at ashram, Guru Maharaj, referring to Sadak, said that you say you are here now, and your house is there, and your family members are there. But Buddha says, nobody is there. If you are there, then only they are there. If you are not there, then they are also not there. Can this be explained, please? Is it the same as a dream where one people and places involved in that particular scene exist? No. It's exactly not same. It's a very, very different thing. Buddha said that there is a non-existence of world. And what you call as I is also a non-existence. Meaning there is no I, there is no you, and whatever elemental world you are seeing is actually just a shunya. It's a, like in a kshana. Kshana can be called a 1,000th part of 1 second. So in that one kshana, 1,000th part of a second, the four elements intermingled and created a form for you. And they say in that one kshana, that world was there. And actually then in next kshana, it was not there. So whatever you see is actually the forms getting formed in that one kshana, but actually there is just shunyata or the emptiness. And in that emptiness, the whole world and your sense of I am, I exist, whatever you think about yourself, all the adjectives which you have, all the degrees which you have for yourself, all the family relations, all the accessories which you have. I'm a poet, I'm a dancer, I'm a musician, I'm this, I'm that, I'm this and that. Whatever you think about yourself, this I too is actually a fluke. There is nothing called I. Hence, Buddhists do not believe in existence of Atma. And Buddhists do not believe in existence of Paramatma, or what you would call a God. And they say, what is it? They say, it's just shunya. And whatever is seen is a very transient things. Even your body isn't the same what it was a second ago, a minute ago, definitely than a day ago, or a month ago, or a year ago. So this is a continuous change which is occurring in the body. And that which is changing, so that change is a phenomenon which is going to always happen. And what is in the remainder? You see, there is nothing in the remainder. Everything is just a very lucid and very flowy and transient and changing. And when I said that if you think that you are here, then your house and family is also there. And if you think you are here, then they exist. And if you, this body, now in the Vedantic perspective, not the Buddhist perspective, in the Vedantic perspective, the body, the mind, the senses, the intellect, the consciousness is not me. So in a way, the body which you think is me is actually not you. So who are you? If not body, if not mind, if not intellect. So in a way now you are non-existent. And now if this is non-existent, then so are those people in the home, and so are those people in the offices and outside world and everywhere. We wish to understand what is world without understanding what is this body and what is this mind. So if with great knowledge and great understanding, if somebody comes to this conclusion with the great clarity and conviction, I am not this body, mind, intellect, I am not this ego, and I am what? Now, in speaking, if I use the words, I know you will parrot it, you can parrot it, and people have parroted it. But it's not about parroting that word. It's about exploring and knowing oneself that I am Sat, Chit, I am Anand, I am a Vyapak. I am not the one who is just encased and imprisoned in this physical body, but I am the one existence which is omnipotent and omniscient. And this omniscient existence is a non-dualistic existence. There isn't a God and you, and now God is angry with you, or you are separated from God. In that non-dualistic philosophy, which is not just a philosophy alone that is jamming of some words, but it is something which is an actual experience which one can have. So once somebody has understood this experientially, for them, neither this body exists nor any other body anywhere.